Peggy, congratulations on such a long and great career in Pittsburgh. I remember when you came to Three River Stadium to our office to introduce yourself to my father and myself back many years ago. Seems like just yesterday. So on behalf of everybody here at the Steelers, we just want to wish you all the best. Thanks for all your contributions to our community, and much happiness to you and your family.
Hey, Peggy, congratulations on your retirement. Oh, that is so wonderful. Wow. You're going to be stepping into the whole new life of being retired. I hope that you and your family are well, the kids, Mike, everyone. I miss you so much, and I do hope that I will see you at some point, whether in Pittsburgh or in Florida or someplace. But I just wanted to pass along this note of huge congratulations to you. I know you're going to miss everybody at WPXI, but there is so much life beyond. So go enjoy it, and let's connect soon. Take care.
Peggy, thank you for coming into our homes for 31 years, showing us how to smile, how to laugh, telling us the information that sometimes made us cry. But all the while, you were professional, you were brilliant. And I want to say thank you for being the person that you have been. I've been a big fan of yours, and I'm going to miss you as well as all of Pittsburgh. So with this retirement, it doesn't mean goodbye. It means see you later.
Hi, Peggy. It's Corey O'Connor. I just want to give you a thank you for many years of serving the people of the city of Pittsburgh. I remember watching you when I was a kid, visiting you at the station with my dad, and it's just an honor that we were able to have you represent the city and Channel 11 for so many great years. You will be sorely missed, but we will never forget you, and thank you very much.
Greg, we're up here where the left field loonies are, and there's a vicious rumor going around in Pittsburgh that Peggy Finnegan is retiring after 31 years. What is going on?
Well, you've got nothing to talk about. First of all, she's following your lead, Steve. I mean, it was just over a year ago you decided to retire. You called it quits, and now after 31 years, Peggy's saying goodbye. You know, you lose a top-of-the-rotation starter. Man, that's not easy. So good luck to WPXI. But more importantly, we congratulate one of the more courageous, classy women we've ever come across, and that's Peggy Finnegan.
Absolutely. We know the background, all the years with PXI, all the challenges along the way. Just want to say, Peggy, that the camera has loved you for a lot of years, and so have we. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Peggy.
Hey, Peggy.
Hi, Peggy.
Lieutenant Governor John and his much better half here, and we just want to congratulate you on an amazing career in local journalism here in the Pittsburgh area, you know?
And you've just always been so kind to me and to us, and we're really going to miss you, miss seeing you on a regular basis. We'll have to just make excuses to get together.
Thank you for your service, and really enjoy your retirement. All our best.
We love you.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, I just want to wish Peggy Finnegan a great retirement. She has had a marvelous, wonderful career here at Channel 11, and I came here about 27 years ago, and Peggy had already been working here for several years by that point. And she's just a tremendous professional, the consummate professional. And it's funny, you really don't know how good she is. And you kind of take it for granted sometimes when you see her up there and how smooth she is, until you have to get the chance to anchor right next to her. Then you understand how good she is. That happened to me 4 or 5 years ago. We were thrown on the anchor desk to fill time between an NBC News special report and Channel 11 News at 5. And they said, Rick, go out there with Peggy. You're going to talk about, it was an airliner crash overseas. And so we had to talk for 45 minutes about an airline crash overseas. And it was remarkable just watching her operate and how smooth she was and how she transitioned from one topic to the next and just kept going, kept the conversation going. And, you know, I remember sitting there going, man, she's good. You know, she knows how to do this. And she's just an incredible professional. And we are really going to miss her here at Channel 11. I tell you, I've had the pleasure of working with her for 27 years now. And you know, we'll never be able to replace her, but I wish her all of the best in retirement and hope she can enjoy some time with those kids and maybe some grandkids in the future. But again, Peggy, you've had a wonderful, remarkable career here, and we are really going to miss you, and we wish you the best in retirement. Congratulations.
Peggy, thank you so much for gracing the television screens here in Pittsburgh. I remember the first day that I actually got to meet you in person here at WPXI. I swear, it was like meeting a superstar. From growing up this big with my parents in the living room, in the kitchen, during dinner and watching you on TV, I can never forget all the great times that you put on TV. Again, thank you so much and congratulations on your retirement.
Well, we want to wish Peggy all the happiness and wealth. She's done a great job. She's been a great Pittsburgher. Came here many years ago in the late 80s when Pittsburgh was a lot different than it is right now. It's not as vibrant, and she came here in those early days, and she's done a great job. She's been a great voice that we've all been able to turn to for reassurance on some of the important news that's happened in this community. So I certainly wish her, the family, they enjoy themselves. We want you to stay in Pittsburgh. Don't go leaving us now. And then hope your kids also enjoy the time they get to spend with you. But well-deserved retirement. Congratulations.
Hey, Peggy, how you doing? Give me a pound. Hey, look, congratulations to you and your retirement. When I moved to Pittsburgh, Mike Oliveira told me that I would get a chance to work with one of the best anchors in the market. And he was not lying. Working with you for the 3.5-4 years was just unbelievable. I learned so much from you about your professionalism and how you attack each day. And I just want to say thank you for being a great role model for me. All I can say is you are one of the best, and Pittsburgh is losing a true gem. Take care and God bless. Bye-bye.
Hello, I'm Ray Carter, Vice President and General Manager of WSB-TV in Atlanta. But before Atlanta, and for 16 wonderful years, I was the GM of WPXI, and I worked shoulder to shoulder with Peggy Finnegan. The world knows some sensations by one single name: Cher, Madonna, Prince. In Western Pennsylvania, if you ever uttered the single name Peggy, everyone knew of whom you spoke. Talented, down-to-earth, and caring. She cares about the Pittsburgh community, about her family and her faith. She cares about the people she covers and the stories she tells. And people returned that favor. They cared about Peggy. Whenever she went on vacation, like clockwork, a couple of days into her vacation, my phone would ring. The person on the other end would say, "Where's Peggy? Is she sick? Did you fire her?" After I assured the caller that Peggy was simply taking some well-deserved time off, the tone of the call would change. I was then treated to a list of reasons why they missed her on the news. What a connection she had with viewers. Happy retirement, Peggy. I feel privileged to have worked with you and to be a proud member of your fan club. Godspeed to you in retirement. Godspeed.
Hi, Peggy. Dennis Bowman here, and it's good to at least be with you by way of video here during these pandemic days. I can't believe it's the last day of your employment at Channel 11. You've given so much to Channel 11 and the Pittsburgh area over all these years. I got to work with you 11 years. You joined us in 1989, and then I left the station in 2000. So 11 on 11 is the way I like to look at it. And maybe that phrase will catch on someday, who knows? Anyway, one of the things I think about when I think about working with you, and of course I go back to the Television Hill days, but the time you and I co-emceed the Channel 11 Carol Sing, the exact date was the day of infamy, December 7th, 1990. And one of the things that happened was, I don't know if you remember this, but a renegade Santa and elves got up on the platform and swarmed over us at the very beginning of the broadcast. I think it was some college kids from Pitt or someplace who, on a bet, said that they could crash the Carol Sing and get up on the stage with us and swarm over us, which they successfully did. It scared us because it wasn't in the script. We didn't know who these people were, and we didn't know what was about to happen, but we trudged along. In case you've forgotten about this, let's go to the 30-year-old videotape, the VHS tape, if you will, and relive that moment from 1990.
Center in downtown Pittsburgh. It's the second annual Channel 11 Carol Sing. Good evening, everyone. I'm Peggy Finnegan.
And I'm Dennis Bowman. for our second annual Channel 11 Carol Sing. We are indeed here at Liberty Center.
Joined by Santa and his elves.
That was a surprise.
It was actually a very big surprise, and we were glad to get through that. Hey, Peggy, oh, by the way, if this video is a little shaky and out of focus, it's not because it was shot by Jack Klingensmith or even Mark Massa, as far as that goes. My wife, Debbie, is doing the honors on her iPhone, and she sends her love to you as well. As do I. Hey, listen, it was great working with you. We live kind of out in the same neck of the woods. I hope and assume we're going to see each other again, especially when the pandemic is over with. Have a wonderful retirement. You're going to love it. As the saying goes, the pay stinks, but the hours are real good.
Peggy Finnegan Donnelly, I understand that you're retiring. Congratulations, Peggy. Many years is well deserved. Peggy, I just want to say thank you for allowing me to be your first director when you came to Pittsburgh. And we worked for a good almost 20 years, you, myself, and GQ David Johnson. And Peggy, it has been a blast. I remember all the fun things we did together. We were so much like a family. And don't forget old Roy Bowman either, you know, and Sammy Hollywood Nova. But the point is, we had a lot of fun while trying to accomplish the goal of becoming number one. And we came damn near close if we didn't do it. But I just want to say congratulations. I remember, Peggy, when Mike and Edie was the previous slogan, Mike and Edie are on this bus. I remember we put them on that bus and rode their ass out of there. And up came the two of you, you and Dave GQ Johnson. And I've never regretted it. It was a blast being your director for both of you. And it was never any regret, never. And I just want to say, Peggy, I thank you because you've always been a pleasure to talk to and be around. And I want to say happy retirement. And remember this, Peggy, you do with those gorgeous eyes and that wonderful smile, you do make me sing the Campbell Soup song all night long. Mm-hmm, good.